Hello, all of you wonderful peoples. I am here. 244. Oh dear God. Why are you awake? That's such an unholy hour. Blah. So, folks. I originally was going to try to play the game Still Life. I don't know if you guys have heard of it or not. But I thought that might be, maybe kind of fun. I tried desperately. Nothing would work. Nothing, 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 nothing. I wanted it in windowed mode, see? And while game hates me. Also, hello, Zen. It's nice to see you. Welcome! So Still Life is a bitch, and now I'm grumpy. So, this is my backup game, which is another mystery-solving adventure, but sadly, it's not funny like Detective Grimoire. This is actually more like a serious, like, we have to find out who killed the rich fat guy on an island of, several suspects and blah blah blah. So you guys get to help me solve a murder. Yay! Wait, what? For a moment, I read that as Spanking Island. Well, you can think of it that way if you really want to. I mean, But, so, here we are. Backup game. Not completely thrilled. You guys are probably gonna be bored with it and just like bleh, and yeah, so yay. Well, excuse the hell out of you, Evan. The hell? What are you on about, dude? Also, Zen, how are you? That was rude of me. Hello. Well, already my ass is popular yet again. Fantastic. Oh God, this is great. This is so great. All right. I'm in the motel. Well then. Wonderful. Okay, so do we need to see my stupid mug or are we good without it? I'll turn it on if you guys want. Hey, woo! God damn! Zen's watching two streams at once? Dude, you're a champ. So, yeah. Webcam, no webcam. Are you guys good without seeing me, or do you really want to see my face? Face or riot? Oh, Evan, that's nice. Having a popular ass is always good, except in prison. I will agree with that. I will definitely agree with that. All right, Evan, since you sort of ask nice, maybe. No. 3 streams? Jesus God! You guys are just multitaskers from hell. I can multitask, but I don't think I could do that. I knew everyone was watching, well, not maybe not everyone, but a lot of people were at Sully's stream. And I was like, oh crap, well, nobody's gonna come here. Everybody's busy, so. Anyway, let's see if this damn thing works. I tried to mess with it earlier. It was kind of working. White birds. I kind of like this whole like TV screen thing. It kind of reminds me of Bioshock. you make sexual jokes in all of them, that is the way to do it. If you're gonna do it in one, you gotta do it in all of them. Every time. I fully endorse that. Wait, I don't think I want to continue. I don't want to start with the game I was playing, because, you know, that's not very fair. Let's see, how are my options here? Yeah, I guess it's okay. My apologies if I yawn, because I'm actually quite tired. Like, I don't... Adventure! Da-da-da! So, yeah. Crime solvers. You guys seeing a pattern to the stuff that I play? It's kind of ridiculous. Really?
Is it a murder?
No, I don't believe so. Walter Jones was already in pretty bad shape.
That was interesting.
So, just a routine check, okay?
Got an error message in chat.
I want to hear.
Never had that before.
Natural causes, with no stories, you understand?
I don't want a crime on my hands right now, see my bill of health, understand?
You're the boss, Vic.
Jack?
Of course.
By the way, can you guys hear it all right?
You're helping me out here, you know?
Get well, Vic. See you soon.
The weather forecast is awful.
Yeah, the chat thingy died. Yeah, totally died it.
Are you sure you don't want to take time to settle in?
All bad. Sorry, guys. Is it working, Evan? Guys? Anything? I gotta wait until this stupid cutscene here is done, which I clicked, so you missed a little bit of it, but that's okay. I'll check in a second. As soon as this is done. Look, there's our dead guy. Big and fat, laying on the beach like a bloated whale.
I beg you to pardon me for this somewhat acrobatic descent.
Yes, I missed your Bioshock Infinite thing because... Yeah, chat just completely was like, you know what, it...
Higher up in the rocks close to the edge. The waves must have sent the poor man's body rolling toward the bottom.
IRS warming. What?
We suffered a terrible storm, you know.
Okay, finally chilled out. Oh, it's working. You gotta stop fat fingering everything, man. Big and bad and dead. Like, look at him. He's all... Bleh.
Inspector, I'm entirely at your service to answer any questions that may come to your mind.
Alright, dude. Shut the hell up. I'm checking something. Alright, so it appears it's working now. At least on my end. It seems to be alright. Anyway. Stupid computer. I'm seriously grumpy. Like, I'm not even gonna lie here. Wait, what? Too lazy to type it out tablet again. We'll message it later if I can. You can't copy paste. What? Alright, let's talk to him.
Buzzing in my head.
By the way, their mouths don't move.
What can you tell me regarding the death of Walter Jones?
In my
view,
it is
the weirdest thing.
I'm categorical, Inspector. I saw Baena push Walter over the edge. The identity of the culprit is not a matter of question for me.
This is like a way more in-depth detective grimoire. That one was just silly and funny, and you had to put things together, but this is actually like really working, like trying to solve it. And, yeah.
Now, I was at the restaurant with the guests when
excuse the hell out of me, I don't got a tablet.
I went back to my office maybe a quarter of an hour or
should be an option. Not, that's gay.
As we had agreed upon in the afternoon. Not seeing him come, I looked out of the window, and that's when I saw what could have been a quarrel between Baena, Jumhu, and Walter at the Tortoise Belvedere. He fell to the bottom in his wheelchair. I hurried to help him, but it was raining like mad, and I could not go down to the rocks to get him out of there.
At least I don't have to read all this.
He was no longer moving.
No, out loud.
I think he died.
That saves my voice.
I came back to tell everyone what had happened, and I also immediately called the police.
MDU too. You can't be everywhere. I know, Zen. You gotta pick and choose. I've had to do it several times too. If you're not gonna upset me or hurt my feelings. I really wasn't expecting anybody to show up because other people were streaming and they're probably more important. So, no. So, Android tablet is gay. By the way, the whole thing about this game is that, big fat dead guy on the beach there. He was like some sort of like a philanthropist or something like that, and he was a little weird or something. And he built this place. It's like, I don't know, it's almost like he either built the island or built a bunch of crap on the island, but the island is literally starting to sink, I guess. And then for whatever reason, someone decided to kill him. So we get sent here originally because we thought it was just he died because he was, sick and whatever, but come to find out, he's murdered.
What was your relationship with Walter Jones?
Yay.
I've worked for Walter Jones for over 20 years. Our relationship was always excellent. In fact, he even did me the honor of asking me to call him by his first name. I admired this man immensely, Inspector. I would even say that I had affection for him. And that this was mutual.
Fat fingering.
Tell me, did your boss have a suicidal temperament? Or was he in the habit of taking unreasonable risks?
That sounds dirty. Which, we all know. Fat fingering.
Following severe medical treatment, he suffered from dizziness and fainting spells. What more can I say? You have to tell me everything, Mr. Noland.
No, Inspector. Physically and mentally, Walter Jones was as solid as a rock. He only suffered from a paralysis of the lower limbs, but nothing that could explain this mortal fall.
Seriously, the fact that their mouths don't move, and the movements? Oy. Okay, so this is my handy-dandy little case here. There's stuff that I collect goes there. This is interesting.
Hello, Inspector Jack Norm. Welcome to your personal police assistant. Jack, this device was created to help you in your investigations. The goal of the software system is to rationalize the combination of clues, evidence, hypotheses, and deductions, which will allow you to quickly uncover the criminals.
This is not bizarre.
For this, your personal police assistant will store all information you will collect about the suspects during your investigations. It will remember their age, gender, and function. The incriminating and exculpatory evidence
are also super high tech.
In addition, it will indicate in real time their geographical position in the surrounding areas where you might need to find them during your investigation. The clue manager will centralize all of the information that you have collected, whether it includes photos, documents, material evidence, or even suspects' statements. In your hands, you have more than a motor for matching clues that you will have collected. You also have a great tool for comparing them. This function will be particularly useful for validating the match between two.
You know, when I saw that half black, half white face, I thought of the Michael Jackson song. Black and white.
You can trust your personal police assistant to validate the hypothesis and to keep you from being misled into dead ends.
Am I alone in this?
This device includes a third function, which strictly depends on the two others. It is your progress manager. It divides your investigation into a certain number of precise interrogations.
Yeah, this is literally a puzzle.
Your job becomes a child's game, Jack. When you know how to respond correctly to all of these questions, you will have solved your investigation.
Dun dun dun. Look, it finally shut up. So, we have him so far. Yeah. Great, huh? Then, we have documents. preliminary information. And we have dipstick here. Blah, blah, blah. Which we just heard him talk all that. Blah, blah, blah. Anyway. So. This handy dandy little thing here. Yeah, this stuff is just really weird. Alright, so let's go check out the dead guy.
A nail implanted in the cheek. His attacker wasn't light about it. At first glance, the body doesn't show signs of death by drowning or hypothermia. And this injury on the forehead seems too superficial to have caused the death. It's the forensic expert's job now. It's for him to tell me what killed Walter Jones.
Dun dun dun! Yeah. So, there we have it. Dead guy. Yay!
Excuse me, just one question. It won't be too long.
I need to talk to this guy about...
distracted. I have what I need. See you later.
Alright then, you freaking fruit loop.
First, I have to transmit my conclusions to Reeves as quickly as possible.
Sucks. Alright, so... him, yeah. Picture there. Okay. We did
something. Is Walter Jones's death accidental?
We did a thing.
The death of Walter Jones seems to be criminal.
If I pull out, bad things will happen. That's awesome.
Reeves, it's Jack. The forensic expert's gonna have work. The death seems suspicious. A fall from a few meters that leaves scratches and an embedded nail in the face? It's not all that clear, you understand?
Jack, if it's like you said, I'm afraid you'll have to prolong your stay. Sorry. I didn't want to impose this on you. You have carte blanche to confirm this. Good luck.
Look, we got another thing.
I will wait for the coroner's report before I affirm anything.
Coroner's reports. Fun stuff. Now it lets me climb the ladder.
What do you
so
say?
So y'all dead?
Inspector.
Like, what happened?
The boss was murdered.
Well, I guess this list will be useful. It has the identities of all the people who currently reside on the island. And here's the key to your room. Because now, I suppose you're going to be staying a while. I remain at your disposition, Inspector. Especially to give you a tour of the tower. It's huge, you know.
Thanks. I think I can manage.
Fine. I'll leave you then. See you later, Inspector.
Bye-bye now.
Ah, here we are. Something interesting. Seemingly, Walter Jones was not alone the moment he had his great fall. The wheelchair made a chaotic journey before falling off the cliff.
I think that's it. Okay. All right, there's the dead guy. This is the guy we met. Let's see, this is the dead guy's grandson. And this is some chicky. Whatever, dude. Look at all these people. Oh, crap. Boy. Alright, so we got some beads from a necklace that we picked up. We got pictures. And that's a list of all the people. Okay. And then, anything here? Oh, look, it's another thing. Yay! Okay. Alright, so can I look at this? Or is he gonna like fall off or something? Wow, okay. That's cool. The frickity frick happened? So, did everyone disappear? Am I alone? Is that what's happening? Nobody loves me. I'm all alone. All alone. Oh crap. Big Bird dicks. Yeah. Rapture did something, and it's with my butt. Imagine that. Crap. Yeah. Fuck a duck, screw a kangaroo, and 69 a porcupine.
Missing on the armrest.
Very good, Sherlock. Butts are awesome. My Matt seems to agree because he can't keep his hands off of my butt all the time, every day, like nonstop.
Walter Jones must have hit himself here.
So I guess that's a good thing that,
rock.
You know, he likes it. I should have known. The what in the butt song? Is that what you're talking about? Because, you know, I know about the song. Right. Oh, wait.
I need some graphite powder to take this print. The architect must have some drawing material. I can make myself some.
So I need to go get dusting powder. What kind of a detective are you? Aren't you supposed to have this stuff? Is there anything else I can do with this thing? I have to make sure I do all the things. I don't see anything else. Okay. Anything else suspicious? Is that just a look at the... Yeah, it's just a look at the chair again. Evan, that's fantastic and creative. Wait, what? Oh, well, yeah, that's what I was hoping, that it's, you know, it's because I just happen to have a fantastic tushy that he can't not touch it, or he just really, you know, loves me. And, you know. Hey, I gotta say, after 4 years that, you know, he's still that addicted to me. I must be doing something right. There is my key card for my hotel room. Excuse me. Ninja grab it. Yes. Well, yeah. Yeah, you make a good point, Rapture. You But that's still, it's still gonna hurt. It's just the doggy style would be like way more painful. Holy shit. What do we got? Chain fragment. Beads from a necklace. And a picture of that. Okay. Well, there we go. Wait, what? Excuse me. Alright, well, I guess we can go back up here now. I looked at the body, looked at the wheelchair, I looked at the crazy scene on the ground. Guess that's it? I can start wandering? Walking sim. Oh. Okay, well, I'm assuming these are from his chair coming down here. Is this guy seriously going to walk like everywhere? Can I speed him up? It will. Okay. No. I can make him run. Yay. It's the little things, guys. Really. It's the little things. Ooh, I found something. Yes, you have found some dandies. I did go back in, Evan, and the
to
one
what
that
does this piece of cloth belong?
There was a double in there, so I went in and, you know, fixed stuff. So the quotes are okay now. All right, what did I pick up? A scrap of gray fabric, full of yellow lichen. It clearly comes from a piece of clothing. The chain, obviously a piece of jewelry, and the beads were probably from a necklace. Well, okay. How? I don't know that there's anything else right here that I can touch. So, we'll run. Aww. I'm sorry, Zen. So, I feel bad. Run, trucker, run! You are getting your ass rained on. Is there anything else to touch and do? Apparently not. Run! Hey, look, it's here. Okay, apparently there's nothing to interact with, so we'll just keep running. Oh my god, is she gonna hump that pole? What is happening? Hey, lady. Wait, why are you running? No, come back. Hey. He is just like doing stuff all by himself.
Me too, Lorenzo. It's a pleasure to see you.
I would have preferred that we see each other in other circumstances.
You don't always have the choice.
Did your grandfather's death affect you deeply?
I don't know. I just can't believe it.
I had problems because of him. But they all went away after his tragic death. In the end, Jones was a good man.
Yes, certainly. I don't know what to think.
Would you like to change the subject?
No, not especially. I'm just a little off, that's all.
The sky is melancholic. Like us, Sonya.
It's true. Perfect weather for a burial.
Well, these guys sure are the life of the party. Why is he just automatically doing stuff? Stop! You walk your happy ass right the fuck back up them steps. I'm not done up there. Anyway, what did I miss? Oof. You're gonna have to be on a vigorous job hunt? Is that just to completely be able to support yourself? Or to help your mom? I'm kind of confused, Evan, and I don't want to pry too much because, you know, I don't want to be rude. Do you edit there? Is there anything to touch and do? Nice. So that means I have to fix this. And apparently your internets are like making you very angry again. No, she was touching this pole. Can I like not interact with it? I want to do stuff. I could probably chase her. But then I won't know what these guys are talking about down there. Alright, go down there. Ugh. Evan, send him the bag of dicks. It's the way to go.
Too bad that the weather is so bad. I would have liked to try out my new bikini.
Forecast for the next few days isn't so good. But, you never know.
Whatever, dude. Go there and shove it up there.
Hey,
nice.
Inspector Jack Norm. I am charged with conducting the investigation of the death of Mr. Jones.
Delighted, Mr. Inspector. Lorenzo Battaglieri. I'm the architect and the mastermind behind this tower in which you'll stay.
Hey, he's the guy we gotta steal the stuff from to get powder for dusting for fingerprints, since I'm clearly a very inept detective.
What can you tell me regarding the death of Walter Jones?
Why is there no mouth animation? Really?
It's Hubert de Nolan who woke me up to tell me about this business. I've got nothing more I can tell you.
It's weird.
Where were you and what were you doing last night?
I spent the evening in my studio listening to the radio. Then I learned of Jones' death from Nolan.
What was your relationship with Walter Jones?
Our dealings, both professional and more so personal, were never simple, Mr. Norm. But I appreciated that he was a character.
Oh, crap.
A man who had talent. I must confess that I'm more affected by his death than I had thought. It's just the way it is, you know. My artistic temperament has always pushed me to be a little bit sentimental.
I wish they had facial movements, because that would be great. Mm-hmm. I don't know if I need to, like, show him anything.
What do you think of the attorney, Hubert de Nolent?
Nolent is a crafty and slick man. I don't trust him, Inspector.
Well, darn you too, man.
Did you see anyone at the Tortoise Belvedere last evening, or did anything at all catch your attention?
I can't answer your question, Norm. I wasn't there.
Come on, Four Eyes.
Do you know anything about medicine?
No, of course not. What a question.
Too bad. I really need some medical advice. Well, I will wait for the coroner's report.
He's just randomly going to ask people.
To whom could this shred of cloth collected from the rocks of the Belvedere belong?
I don't know. It's... No, I know nothing at all, really.
He just lied. That sumbitch just lied.
Do these pearls mean anything to you?
No. No, really, they don't mean anything to me.
Who is the rightful owner of this piece of chain?
It seems to me that Walter Jones wore a small chain like that.
These footprints near the tracks of the wheelchair lead me to think that there was an argument which got out of hand.
Maybe. I'm not a policeman. I'm nothing but a poor architect.
My Achilles story!
Did Walter Jones die following the first impact on hitting the rocks? Or from what happened to him when he fell?
It's hilarious. I can just ask people this stuff.
How should I know, Norm? I'm no forensics expert.
This is funny. Okay, I gotta stop asking him this stuff, because clearly...
I understand.
He's just... What did he say? Dumb architect. There he is. Architect and building manager. Difficult relationship. He was in a studio, supposedly. Likely story in here. Look at you. He doesn't have confidence in me. Wonderful. So I'm doing well, basically.
Good morning, ma'am. Jack Norm. I'm a police inspector, and I'm charged with the investigation of the death of Mr. Walter Jones.
Good morning, Inspector. Sonia Jones. I'm the granddaughter of Walter Jones. You know, I hadn't thought that my time in Segura would take such a dramatic turn.
If it doesn't bother you, I'd love to take a photo of your hands, please.
Your method of flirting is very questionable, Inspector. But that's what you want.
Why didn't you take a picture of Dipstick's hands? Like, what the fuck? The shit.
Go on, I'm listening, Inspector.
Ever since the tech guy fixed the router. I hate that. We've had in the past, now this was like years ago, mind you, techs that come out and they're like, oh yeah, it's totally this. And they like kind of just fiddle a little bit with some of the cables and plugs and, oh, this was kind of loose and blah, blah, blah. And then they leave. And it's like, yeah, I know they didn't fix anything. I'm not an idiot. And the problem's still there or worse. And then you still have to call again and then have somebody else come back out. And hopefully the person that comes back actually knows what they're doing. Wow, timing on that quote right before Rapture's comment. As far as I know, those aren't anal beads. They're beads from a necklace, but, you know, whatever.
Do these pearls mean anything to you?
These pearls of mean no value, something Inspector, to you, lady.
Like the ones worn by the indigenous people of the archipelago. No, they don't mean any more than that to me.
Oh, she's a conceited bitch.
Who is the rightful owner of this piece of chain?
I do have the impression that my grandfather wore something that looked like it. It's pretty ugly in any case. Even if we agree it's
made of
gold.
Yeah, you have to raise all the tax support. Yeah.
Yes, I do believe, but at the same time, I'm not sure.
What can you tell me regarding the death of Walter Jones?
It was Hubert de Nolent. You met him, I believe. He told me about the death of my grandfather. Nolan went to the site to rescue my grandfather, but it was too late.
I actually don't have much of a knowledge of sex, so I thank you very much.
And Billy and Clara, too, so we stayed here.
I just might appear that I do.
This hyena was there, according to what Nolan
told us. But I don't really.
There's no way that she could have a clear conscience.
You guys.
Where were you and what were you doing last night?
I spent the evening with my brother Billy and my sister-in-law Clara, Mr. Norm. It was Hubert de Nolent, my grandfather's attorney, who informed us of his death.
I should have knowledge of sex toys. See, that's the one thing I never got into. Everybody else did. I never did. Still haven't. Not sure that I will. I know that might seem strange, but it's the truth.
What was your relationship with Walter Jones?
You know, Mr. Norm, my grandfather was a tough man. He wasn't the sort of grandpa who spoiled my two brothers and me. I didn't feel at ease with him, and our relationship has been tense for a long time. When he made the first move to invite us here, I was surprised. He was really proud, and that touched me. I'm horrified by the conditions under which he died, and I am sad. Yes, I am saddened by his death. It's odd, isn't it?
Really, Evan? Well, Evan, you kind of walked into that one. Gets a date. What? Yeah, as far as sex toys and stuff are concerned, I actually prefer a actual, you know, warm, alive penis attached to a real live person that's also in turn doing things to me too. I really am not into anything fake. I prefer the real stuff. It's always better. Moving on.
What do you know about Lorenzo Battaglieri?
Lorenzo is an old friend, Inspector. We've known each other for a long time. He's a refined and charming man. Someone dependable.
Hi, Zen.
What do you think of the attorney, Hubert de Nolent?
Hubert de Nolent is definitely a remarkable man, Inspector. Intelligent, adroit, and terribly efficient.
Maybe I've let you in too much to my preferences? Back to the game.
Did you see anyone at the Tortoise Belvedere last evening, or did anything at all catch your attention?
I spent the evening with my brother Billy and my sister-in-law Clara. We were relaxed, and we all chatted. I saw nothing and I heard nothing, Mr. Norm. Sorry to disappoint you.
Human heaven! Why you do this? Yeah, I'm sorry. I do. I prefer the real thing. I've been dogged about it a lot. A lot of female friends in the past. What's wrong with you? How is that? I'm sorry. I like a live man. I don't want a piece of plastic. I don't know. I want a real honest to God penis attached to a dude that I got the hots for. There. I said it. Okay, now I'm gonna go back to the game now.
Do you know anything about medicine?
No.
In that case, you can't help me. I get it.
You get what, dumbass? Ugh. This guy. Seriously. Ah! Picture of her hands. And her belly. Okay. Well, just great. Can I, like, room? Well, she was there and in a studio. I'll just stick you there anyway, because I don't even fucking care. Whatever. You. I don't know, we'll just stick you there for the time being. Seeing as how I really don't know what the fuck I'm doing. Anyway. Okay, where's the sheet that you're gonna talk to? Nope. Her. She's the chick I just talked to. Okay. Evening in a restaurant. Let's see if they can corroborate that story. I think you're all lying. And I don't like liars. I gotta go, people. We have fun standing in the rain. Weirdos. Is she hiding from me? Hey, lady! Damn it! Why you gotta run from me? Huh? Why? What is your problem, woman? Ew, what the shitballs. Ow. This is... Wow. Well, you're hiding over here, so I'm gonna try to jump you. Stop running from me. God damn it! Dude, when I catch up to this lady, I'm gonna tackle her. I'm just gonna tackle her, and I'm gonna smack her around. I'm gonna tell her to stop running from me. Or something. I don't know. Oh, whoa. Okay, where do I go? This way? Fuck, I don't know. Ugh. I'm like literally in the middle of nowhere. And there's nothing to click on, there's nothing to do except just keep running. Yes, I have to get her from behind. Element of surprise. Or something like that. Fucking shit. With all of this running, am I seriously having to chase this bitch down? Like, is that what I'm doing right now? Because I don't want to do that. Freaking shitty shit shit balls. It's like a running sim. Yeah, guys, this is so much fun. Look, it's a crab. Yay, apparently I can't go that way. I can only go this way. Now I'm way off track of getting back into that mother tower. It, whoa. Hey guys, what's going on? Woman? Get her, dude. Sick her. Come on. Take her down.
Yes, I'm Jack Norris.
No, don't be polite.
I'm a police inspector. That means I will conduct an investigation about the death of Mr. Jones.
Inept.
Walter Jones, you understand?
Inept detective.
My daughter has not spoken for years. Leave her alone. She has nothing to do with all your cop business.
If it doesn't bother you, I'd love to take a photo of your hands, please.
She's mute.
Thanks. This finger with a broken nail makes me strangely think of the tip of the nail that was left embedded in old Jones's face.
An alternate reality. Really? I don't know why, but that just doesn't seem... I don't know, something about that just doesn't sound right to me, but I'm not saying that it's not true, but...
I'm collecting footprints. And I'd like to add yours.
The city.
Shy girl.
Clearly. Can you not just, yeah, take the footprints from where she just ran, dipstick? Ugh.
Here are the footprints of the young Baina.
All right. So now, sweet Jesus, now we have footprints. Holy shit. Rapture is in an alternate reality? No shit. Is it really? Man, I feel like, everything's just been turned upside down. I don't even know what anything is anymore. I'm 1001% confused. Really? Wow. Okay. I have not played it. Not sure if I ever actually will, but...
Good morning, sir. I'm Jack Norm. I'm a police inspector. I'm investigating the demise of Mr. Walter Jones.
I saw the helicopter, Jack Norm. I am Coolio. I have been a fisherman here forever. My daughter's name is Baina. She lives here with me. Zagora is an island blessed by the gods. Old Jones is dead, and it's sad. But he was lucky to die in Zagora.
Okay, old guy.
What can you tell me regarding the death of Walter Jones?
Old Jones was a bad guy, that is for sure. So he had enemies. That is how it is. This man was asking for trouble.
The last is very confusing now. Okay.
Where were you and what were you doing last night?
I was in the cabin with my daughter, Baina.
His alibi is a mute.
What was your relationship with Walter Jones?
Sometimes we had hatred. Sometimes we liked each other. But we did not know each other well. I do not know if I am sad or not. I would have liked to say goodbye to him, to Walter Jones. That's all.
Takes place in an alternate reality from 1 and 2. That's very interesting. Wait, what? Wow.
To whom could this shred of cloth collected from the rocks of the Belvedere belong?
It is the sea that snags all this in the rocks, I tell you, Jack Norm. It comes from another part.
Do these pearls mean anything to you?
There are lots of pearls on the island, Jack Norm.
That's such an interesting story. The Bioshock story or this weird game?
Who is the rightful owner of this piece of chain?
Because so far this is like...
One finds many things in the rocks.
You're a dipstick.
I would love it if you could tell me a little about Sonya.
No one can control Sonya. Sonya is a strong and free woman, like Zagora.
Okay.
What do you know about Lorenzo Battaglieri?
Lorenzo is a good man, Jack Norm. Lorenzo helped Baina after the terrible accident. Lorenzo has always been good with Baina and Colio.
He wants to bang your daughter, dude. Yes, I am.
What can you tell me about your daughter?
Baina is Colio's son. And Colio is willing to break Jack Norm's head if Jack Norm says bad things about Baina.
I do believe we just got threatened.
What do you think of the attorney, Hubert de Noland?
I do not like judges and lawyers who are like gods, Jack Norm. Gods alone should be gods. And I like policemen worse still than judges and lawyers, Jack Norm.
Both. Your face too there, dipstick. Ah, whatever.
Oh yeah.
Jerk. You spoiled who Elizabeth really is. Pretty sure you shouldn't have done that. Damn mother bitchin' son of a whore. Is chat still functioning for you guys? Because that error thing just popped up again. Wait till you find out who Comstock is. Hey, did you guys notice that I colored the quotes so that it actually stands out and doesn't blend in with everything? I have Puff to thank for that. And pretty much all of this. Anyway. God bless it. Had to, guys, sorry. Okay, so he... I can take a picture of this?
Strange construction.
Shit, I didn't know I could take a picture of anything. Bloody hell. Can I, like, go in your house and, like, steal stuff from you? I can go in your house and steal stuff from you! Ooh! And they're totally not even stopping me. What the hell? I just stole something! I just stole something. Oh, I just stole more stuff! I like stealing things. It makes me feel better about myself. Anything else I can touch? Anything? Got any more stuff I can take? Because that was fun. Let me have more of your stuff. Can't take nothing else. Damn it. So who is he? Let's see who goes to it. Ha ha ha. Nice. Alright, what did I find? Yeah, no spoilers. Not spoilers. Alright, what else do I got? A gift? Large diamond in a box. It says Walter Jones' initials on it. In all likelihood, a gift that he offered. What? Oh my. Wait, what? Went to get more tea. Dude, gotta say you're leaving before you leave. Okay, I don't think there's anything else I can steal from them. I should probably go. I can't believe they didn't, like, freak out and, like, chase me in here. Like, get out of my house! Hut! My thing! Stop touching stuff! You know. Okay. Well, goes to the bathroom. Okay. You do that. I have to run a lot to go back. Fuck what? Your internet's provider again. That'd be my guess. Yep. I was right. Yeah, I think you need to get a tech out there that actually knows what he's doing. Clearly that guy was useless. Why can I not fast travel? Cause this sucks. Dumbest thing ever. Third time? Well, can go in there. Can I go up on this thing and do something before I go in the giant tower? You know, PC's going back that way. Alright, well, I guess we're going to the ginormous mother tower. I'm pretty sure that's like, you know, it's compensating for something. You know what I mean? You men. Really? I have to click on the stupid thing instead of you just walking in? Whoa. Wow. The tower lounge. Jesus, which way do I go, George? I guess we'll go straight.
Hello? Anyone here?
Where the white women at?
This place is disproportionate.
Do I go that way? Up? Or that way? I'm right-handed, so we'll try to go to the right first. Dude, I am so gonna get lost in here. Empty ball bladder. That's funny. Oh, those were steps right there. Durf. And this is nothing. Wow, that was a waste of my time. What's over here? Run! Elevator? Okay. Well, now I know what's over here. I double-clicked. Run, you fucker! We'll go to the right. Or left. Yep, I know my directions. Alright, what do we got over here? Anything? Yeah. Oh, hello. We have a desk that appears to be unattended. Where the fuck is everybody? Okay. Why you do this? Tourist pamphlet showing the merits of the tower, the island, as well as the architect. Ah! A paradise at the heart of the Maldivian archipelago. Okay. Soars 150 meters above. Wow. Okay, and the point of this is what? Back again, oy-vey. Yeah, oh. 54 rooms, 6 suites. Yeah, there's the helipad. That's what I arrived on, but you guys didn't get to see it because I clicked like a dumb stick. Restaurant, bar, Uncle Brown, blah, blah, blah.
Jones really wanted to make this tower into a super luxury hotel.
And it is. Freaking shit, dude. Oh, it's a menu. Man, this is some uppity food. What? French-influenced gastronomic menu. Wow, that's some... You see the little hand, how it like actually like flexes it. Again, little things, guys. Little things. Okay. Still not getting anywhere because nobody's fucking here. Dickhead was supposed to meet me. The French are weird. Yeah. As a result of the tower's final construction stages, this elevator is out of service. Thanks for understanding. Dirt. Okay. Well, you know. I think we're all weird. Rapture, to be honest. Well, we're all pretty bonkers. But that's okay. I'm good with that. Let's just start wandering around. Oh my god, with the slow climb. Shoot me now. This is like the stair climbing in like Resident Evil. It's like boom, 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 boom. I'm like, ah. Why? Alright, I'm at the lounges. Can I go this way? I can go this way. What's this way? Hello. Oh, is this like the restaurant? Can I find a restaurant? Hey man, give me some food. And a beer while you're at it. Come on. There's nobody? Oh, if there's nobody here, why can't I just walk over here and just start chugging alcohol? Like, seriously. Come on. People! Wait, where are you? I haven't met you yet.
Good morning,
hey, what's
miss.
Going on?
My name is Jack Norris. I'm a police inspector. To conduct an investigation on the death
what
of
is
Walter
she wearing?
Jones.
Good morning, Inspector. I am Christina Bromsky. I am the girlfriend of Marco Jones, and Mr. Walter is not from my family.
I'm going to say
I
it.
Didn't know him well.
I'm going to call
I
this.
I don't like this place, which is full of sadness for Marco today.
If it doesn't bother
this foreign
you,
lady's shirt is painted on, it ain't even real.
Go on, Jack. You're the police. One can't refuse you anything.
Boobs. What the...
Thanks.
Your questions are splendid. Continue. I love this.
She wants to D. Give me some food and beer while you're at it. Oh my god, Evan. Walter, now.
What can you tell me regarding the death of Walter Jones?
I don't know anything, Jack. It's the attorney who told us everything. He almost died to save the old man. Such courage is beautiful.
Excuse
me. Don't you agree, Jack?
Sorry.
Where were you and what were you doing last night?
I apologize if that was
loud. I spent the evening in the room with Marco. We were both there. Sonia told us about the
banging.
Death of Mr. Jones.
You were both there banging.
11:30 p.m.
She looks dirty. Come on. She looks dirty.
What was your relationship with Walter Jones?
I didn't know Mr. Jones well, Jack. But I feel bad for Marco.
Oh, welcome back,
loved
Zen.
He his grandfather so much.
I'm being completely vulgar and retarded. And thank you, Rapture. Restaurant menu? Yeah, I don't need to show that. No.
Who is the rightful owner of this piece of chain?
I can't tell it all, Jack. Is it okay if I call you
She so
Jack?
Wants to date.
No.
Come on, she's
call
so
me
flirting.
Whatever you prefer.
So flirting. She wants it.
I would love it if you could tell me a little about Sonia.
Sonia is not as nice as she seems. I am possibly the only one who sees the truth about this. She is a snob who was born with a silver spoon in her mouth. She thinks only of herself. She looks down on those who cannot give her something. My life in this family is not very easy, you know, Jack?
Myrtle! The frick, dude! Where you been, man? I gotta fix this. There we go. Myrtle, Myrtle, Myrtle. Okay, you guys can start attacking Myrtle now.
What do you think of Colio?
The old man who lives near here? I don't know him.
What do you know about Lorenzo Battaglieri?
Lorenzo is a very charming man. He has a sort of tragic humor, which reminds me of my countrymen.
Lurking.
I like him.
Skulking. Back.
What do you think of Baina?
I meant jump him as in, you know.
I am sorry, Jake.
People start using the commands.
Dang
it, man. You know, everyone just start groping you and humping you or whatever. I don't know. Oh, Evan, you're like all over the quotes today. Myrtle's gonna hug himself because nobody else hugged him yet.
What do you think of the attorney, Hubert de
Nolent? That's a good quote.
Hubert de Nolent is a pretentious and arrogant man, Jack. He is even humiliating sometimes. A lowlife.
Oof. Wow. Thank you, Myrtle. Hugs. Because I can't really, you know.
This menu seems utterly appetizing. Tell me, what are we eating today?
So you're a gourmand, Inspector Norm.
Nah.
This tower on this wild island, far from everything, isn't it madness?
The photos are more beautiful than real life, Jack. The island doesn't enjoy good weather, and it's deadly boring.
Okay.
You came to liven up the place.
Oh my God, she so wants to haunt me. Do you hear this lady?
Walter Jones gave this to Baina, didn't he? What were the bonds that connected them?
A diamond. One has to find the woman, Jack. Walter Jones was still very young, wasn't he? Despite his age. He must have used the gift to... In short, you see what I'm saying, Jack?
He lured the young mute girl to bone him? Is that what you're getting at?
Did you see anyone at the Tortoise Belvedere last evening, or did anything at all catch your attention?
I don't know anything about it, Mr. Norm. I spent the evening in my room with my boyfriend, Marco. After dinner and a short hand of poker, I learned the death of Walter Jones on 11:30
p.m. God, I need to stop. God damn it.
I see.
All right, ladies, sit your horny ass down. I gotta talk to this dickhead. I got so much, oh Jesus, I got so much stuff. She's not fond of him, didn't know him well, and she was with Margo. Strip poker. Yeah, she wants to climb in like a tree. Or just, you know, grind me like a stripper
Penny
pole.
For your thoughts.
Oh, Jesus, God.
You're incorrigible.
Did that show up on screen, by the way? Okay. Earth. Scared the bejesus out of me. Oh, God. Damn it. Whew. Okay. Myrtle, I believe, God bless it, what just happened? Myrtle. I have not got a message, so I will have to look if you sent one, I don't know. But thank you, Myrtle, that was very sweet of you. I don't know if my stuff's working, to be honest. I don't. I don't even know if the box popped up to show you the cool thing that I have. Probably didn't. It's strip poker. Yeah, the mouth not moving thing when they talk, it just broke. Oh, that's driving me nuts. Gotta get new beard back. Oh my god. Yeah, so did anyone see the pop-up notification for the donation that came in? Anybody at all? Let me see. I'm going to become the top D rather than that Myrtle. I heard that Myrtle's a pretty cool guy, though, just saying. Thank you, Batman. Awful nice of you. Aw. It was there? It did show up?
Yes!
I worked really hard on putting that together. Just so you guys know. Anyway, yeah, thank you, Batman, Myrtle. Yeah. Oh, that reminds me. I don't think I have this other thing working. Excuse me. I forgot to do something. Like a dummy. I think I broke it. Nope, there it goes. Ha! That's so nice. It wasn't the I don't know, Rapture's over there, you know, get naked and just, yeah. So, you know, I got that going for me. God damn it. Sorry, I'm trying to make something work and it's like being bitch tits. A Kappa macro. Oh, God, fuck, shit. Oh, jeez. Crap. God damn it. Alright. Myrtle. Damn it. Arg. Myrtle bought me a game. Because apparently I need to cry. He bought me one heart, which I don't know if you guys have heard of, but it looks kind of twisted. Thank you, Myrtle. Gosh. Oh, no. Why is my stuff not working? I'm gonna cry now. Thank you for immortalizing my freak out, Evan. I appreciate that. I'm wondering if the reason that I'm not, my thing isn't, yeah, there it goes. God, I'm such a bonehead. Alright, make sure this is good. Okay, now, did it update? Yes, it updated. There we go. I forgot to have something on in it. Aw. Huh. Hi, hon. Thanks. You missed it. I got the crap scared out of me twice because Batman donated some money and then Myrtle bought a game and it freaked me out twice. Cause I'm lame. Crap. You guys. Poor Matt is at work tonight and he is very, very sore. So we have to, you know, wish him luck on surviving the rest of work tonight. No, don't walk away. No, no, no. You stay right there.
Good morning, Inspector. Get off your phone. Norm.
I'm the one investigating the death of Mr. Jones.
Anyway, hi.
Ah, it's you who will be investigating.
Good
morning, Inspector. I'm Marco Jones. Walter Jones was my grandfather. I would have preferred if you had...
Anyway, thank you. I
landed on the island of Segura for a sad reason.
And, you know... Yeah, he's sore because of... Well, reasons. Yeah. He'll tell you if he wants. I'm not gonna. A lady's not supposed to kiss and tell, but of course I'm not exactly a lady, so, you know. Shoots that out of the water.
What can you tell me regarding the death of Walter Jones?
How I would have loved to have done something to save my grandfather.
That's a polite way to say it, Rapture. Too dangerous.
It was Noland who gave me the news. He suspects the daughter of the fisherman. But it's you who is the inspector, not me.
Where were you and what were you doing last night?
This guy's a douche.
I spent the evening in my room, in Christina's
company. I
already
don't like him.
It was Sonia who told me around 11:30 p.m. about what had happened. It was difficult to believe it. My grandfather was a real force of nature, despite his handicap.
They're okay.
What was your relationship with Walter Jones?
I greatly appreciated my grandfather. Walter was a great man, Inspector. I admired his rise to success. He did it all alone.
Oh my God, you fat finger in
some... We
were very close
to the stories which my brother and my sister must have endlessly told you about.
Which stories are you talking about?
I'm picking, of course, Evan. It's okay.
We are divided on our opinion about my grandfather, you see.
My
brother and my sister maybe hope to involve you. As far as it concerns me, I've nothing to add.
I just want to smack all these people over the head and be like, one of y'all bitches killed this dude, and you need to tell me which one of you it is. Like, that's my instinct. Is that bad?
This tower on this wild island, far from
everything. I'm probably going to have to reload the
madness?
Thing,
alas,
Evan.
My grandfather will not have the time to successfully finish the magnificent project, of which this brochure gives you only a small taste.
Let me fix it, Evan. Okay, there. Now try again.
Who is the rightful owner of this piece of chain?
Sorry, Inspector Norm, but I'm afraid
thank
I won't
you,
be useful to you.
Smack them all. Actually, I didn't say son of a bitch. I said some bitch. Have I mentioned I've been watching a lot of Smokey and the Bandit lately because Q is like absolutely obsessed with that movie? Because I have. And yeah, you might get references from that because I'm saying a lot of retarded stuff. Anyway, it's okay, Evan, really. It can be fixed. Let's just give you a hard time.
What do you think of Christina?
Meeting Christina was one of the most important events in my life, Inspector. She is my
soulmate. She's my
soulmate. Other. We are in total harmony on all counts.
Uh-huh. This guy is seriously, like, clueless because his woman was just hardcore flirting with me. Like, if this guy wouldn't have been in the room, she probably would have jumped me. Hey man, you can take it how you want. We know the actual context, but anybody reading it can take it how they want. Which just makes it even better.
I would love it if you could tell me a little about Sonia.
Sonia is my
good
sister,
shit.
And I have a lot of affection for her. She is a very strong and courageous woman.
Good shit.
What do you think of Colio?
I saw Colio on several occasions, of course, but I don't know him well.
She's one of them ones that probably would have had to, like, be in control kind of thing, you know, like, bending me over things and whatever. Like, she just seems really just, really dirty.
What do you know about Lorenzo Battaglieri?
Lorenzo is a mystery.
My character should probably just run away before she does jump him.
Bordering on an imposter.
Corner me in my room
he
later.
Takes refuge in a cynical depression that's very unpleasant for others.
Yes, It's a quote from Fred. That's awesome.
What do you think of Baena?
I miss that game already. So fun.
I have nothing special to say on the subject.
Well, do you think
of the attorney, Hubert de Noland?
Noland. He's not a nobody. He's one of the best business attorneys on this planet, Inspector.
So many
It's not
sticks.
By chance that my grandfather recruited him.
Mine was the biggest. Alright.
Did you see anyone at the Tortoise Belvedere last evening, or did anything at all catch your attention?
Sorry, Inspector Norm, but I saw nothing. I, for one, spent the evening in my room with my girlfriend, Christina.
Mm-hmm. Likely story, dude.
I get it.
You get what, dude? What do you get? Oh, Jesus. Mired. Strange pyramid. That's what was back there. Okay, I need to stop doing that. Miss something? What do you mean? Miss something? Why? What are you referring to, hon? Kinda scared now. Hey, if you recall, in the game, my yellow stick was the biggest one. Because, obviously, I'm taller than gnomes. And everyone else was just hitting me with their square fists. That didn't really look right either. Okay, anyway. Okay. Thank you for having sent me all of your friends. Almost all found good work at the hotel. Okay. I know that you recently ran Running Ground. Great misfortune for fishermen. I hope this motorboat. Motorboat. Will relieve some of the fatigue. I'm also very thankful that we've overcome our little disagreement regarding the construction of the tower. You know that you can count on me to assure a serene destiny for your daughter and for yourself. Wow. That actually makes him sound nice.
If I believe this letter, Colio had Jones in his pocket.
Mm-hmm. Sorry. He's Polish? What? Armature? A widower? Paraplegic. Legal action taken against him while CEO following expropriation judgment rendered for the illegal acquisition of the island. Ooh. Ooh, he was the naughty boy. Died at 10:45. Yeah. Throw the natives under the bus, because that's never been done before. Land. Cook up some suspects, please. What? Statements about their whereabouts. I hope it'll help. Up to you to verify and compare the list. Okay. Wait, what now? What's this happening? You added my haha motor bump. And Myrtle Honk Mats. Tush. Hilarious. How many get motorboating to stranger? It's always in pairs. Yes, I know you like motorboating. Good grief. I know that one all too well. Although I fear I've said too much. Please, poker. Marco. Blah, 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 blah. Sweet Jesus. No. That's it? Oops. Fuck you guys then. I don't care. She has nice hands. Boobs. Anyway, what? That nail is busted and funky. Interesting. Hers are all fine. Also, boobs. Send all the pictures of, like, hands and junk. Okay. Interesting. You like that, Evan? Oof. Alright. Blah. Okay. See you. Oh, shit. Anything sitting here? No. I'm gonna just run past you. Nobody? Shit, man. Whoa. Anything? Nothing. Okay, I guess I was supposed to run into them guys to talk to them, but, you know, whatever. Let's just back that way. Yeah, I'll go this way. Let's go over here. He runs so weird. Oh my god. Please tell me you guys saw that. When you see him running from behind, it's hilarious. I'm gonna get lost. I'm gonna get so freaking lost. It just keeps going. Is that a bar? It is. Give me some. Why can I not? Why is this not self-serve? I want a drink. You rat bastards. I hate this place. Can't eat. I can't drink. You're ruining all of my fun. Stupid. Oh, do I go up here? Guess I can. Myrtle, are you still here? Myrtle? What is that? Myrtle, what is this? Come on, Myrtle. Yeah. We have found a piano. Unfortunately, it won't let me bang on it. I want to bang on the piano and it won't let me. Touch the piano! This game officially sucks. It won't let me bang on a piano. Well, at least you got happy for a second. This is where I came up from, right? Yes? Anybody? Why won't stream load on tablet? I don't know. Oh, right there. Then I heard you call me. Myrtle, if you are tired and really sleepy, you can go to bed. It's okay, man. What's this? Ow. Yeah. Well, bloody hell. Oh, I found the kitchen. You don't want to yet? Well, I'm just saying, you know, if you get tired, it's okay. You can go to bed. I could so jump him and like moita his face.
Good morning. Let me introduce myself. Inspector Jack Norm. I'm here to conduct the investigation on the death of Mr. Jones.
Inspector Norm.
Rapture.
I am Martin Abruzzi, the husband of Sonia Jones, the granddaughter of the deceased.
Oh, this is nice. Sonia's hubby, who apparently is kind of a...
What can you tell me regarding the death of Walter Jones?
Mr. DeNoland had us all come together in the restaurant to give us the tragic news. It was a terrible shock for us, as you might suspect. Outside, the storm was raging. Abominable weather.
Raging.
It would have been madness to go out and risk our lives. Because, in truth, we couldn't have brought poor Mr. Jones back to life.
Where were you and what were you doing last night?
I spent the evening at the restaurant with my wife Sonia and the other guests until the departure of Mr. Jones. I returned to my suite at around 10:30 p.m. to read a manuscript, and I soon went to bed. It was Sonia who woke me up to tell me about the tragedy that had taken place.
In my penis storm. Yes. Raging storm. Well done. That would be funny.
What was your relationship with Walter Jones?
I certainly won't try to play any games with you, Inspector. And I won't surprise you if I tell you that I didn't have much affection for this man. He was the grandfather of my wife, full stop. That's it. A grandfather who was not particularly likable. He didn't behave very well with Sonia and me, and I have not forgotten. Therefore, his death truly doesn't affect me.
Because it's complete. Oh, God.
Who is the rightful owner of this piece of chain?
I confess I haven't the foggiest idea.
You lie. Yeah. It's raging. Raging.
What do you think of Christina?
Christina? A Russian model lost here in Segura.
Russian
Quite a
model?
Picture, isn't it? I don't really know her, Inspector. Except, of course, what everyone can see.
I would love it if you could tell me a little about Sonia.
I'm badly placed to answer you with any objectivity, Inspector. Sonia is my wife. Sonia is the woman I love. Sonia is the woman of my life. She is irreplaceable for me.
Oh my God. Then, oh my God, oh my God.
What do you think of Colio?
Oh,
I didn't have the chance
yet another
to spend
brilliant
much time
one.
With Colio, Inspector. I don't really know him.
You and Rapture know what you're doing. Indeed.
What do you know about Lorenzo Battaglieri?
Delicate question, Inspector. I take Lorenzo to be a whimsical creature, somewhat unreliable, and is commonly considered to be an incompetent to boot.
What do you think of Baina?
Baina? The untamed young girl? What can I say?
Oh, God.
I have the impression that maybe she isn't entirely a stranger to Walter Jones's death.
Why would Baina have something to do with Walter Jones's death?
I know the old man ran after her a little. That surely couldn't have been to her taste.
I think he's just jealous.
What do you think of the attorney, Hubert de Nolent?
Oh,
I cannot comment on Mr. de Nolent for the simple reason that I do not know him, Inspector.
What can you tell me about Marco?
I hardly know my brother-in-law, Inspector, but what I do know of him is very positive. I appreciate him a lot. He is someone to reckon with, as they say.
Did you see anyone at the Tortoise Belvedere last evening, or did anything at all catch your attention?
I'm afraid I won't be very useful to you, Inspector. I had dinner with the guests.
With Mr. Guys.
Jones. I stayed for a bit after the old man had left for his evening walk. It must have been around 10 p.m.
So much
then I went
talking.
Back to my apartment. Well, the suite that was reserved for Sonya and me. It was around 10:30 p.m. I wanted to finish reading a manuscript. I'm a publisher, as you certainly must already know. So I read and then I slept. I confess I was pretty exhausted by the trip.
Wait, what? So, since I can't sew anything, I'm gonna be off. I think that is you saying goodbye, Evan, and I'm sorry that everything blows. I hope it gets fixed. ASAP. You know, by someone that knows what they're doing. Poop. Well, bloody hell.
I have to believe you. Thanks.
Okay. There's that guy. That must be him. That's a bit early, blah, blah, blah. Okay. Walk over here. Or run, that works too. Ooh, there's a couple of people. Sweet. Alright, I have to grab something really quickly. Bear with me for just a moment. I will be right back. I needed a drink. I'm a little parched. And a snack. Because I haven't really ate a whole lot today. Alright, who are you scrubbing
the
floor?
I'm Jack Norm, police inspector. I'm mandated to conduct an investigation on the death of Mr. Walter Jones.
Good morning, Mr. Inspector Jack Norm. It's funny. Your name
Sit
is
on
Bell.
It.
Well, anyway, I'm Billy, Billy Jones, grandson and soon heir of the late Walter Jones. Well, at least hope so.
What can you tell me regarding the death of Walter Jones?
I found out about the death of the old man like everyone else at around 11:30 p.m. It was Nolan, his right-hand man, who informed us. This guy risked his life to save the old miser. Unbelievable, huh? The daughter of the fisherman, whatever. She's apparently involved.
Mm-hmm.
Where were you and what were you doing last night?
I was absorbed in a hand of poker and I was having pretty good luck. With Sonia Martin for partners and Nolan, the attorney of my grandfather, came to inform us of the death.
What was your relationship with Walter Jones?
Yeah, I don't really want to tell you stories about my family. But what I can tell you is that I had 1,000 reasons to detest the old man. But I immediately reassure you, Norm, the death of my grandfather took me completely by surprise.
Tell me more about your reasons for hating your grandfather, please.
Principally to do with money, Inspector. I've got a fair bit of debt, and my super-rich grandfather never wanted to lend me a cent. But if you want to go there,
that's because
I would never
kill
anyone for money. Or anything else, for that matter.
This tower on this wild island, far from everything, isn't it madness?
It's all bullshit, this tower.
I
There's
am
not
meeting
even
specs.
A game room here. Not one, Inspector. Can you believe that?
That's what I'm eating. Nom, nom, nom. Pocky is fantastic. Unfortunately, I've only ever had strawberry and chocolate. I want to try some other flavors too, but I haven't been able to yet. You love Pocky? Toad's jealous. Toad's jealous. You know what I'm upset about here is that this should be bigger-ish. I know when that border pops up, it's you're not gonna be able to see it, but I don't even really care right now. Right there. Anyway, Toad's jealous. Yeah, I have a fondness for Pocky, and our grocery store, a Meyer's actually, carries it. It's like. Thank you.
Who's the rightful owner of this piece of chip?
Otherwise, I have to order
it. Sorry, but I don't know anything about this one.
Yeah, he sends the women like just into a complete utter just a rapture. He's that good. That's that Bioshock. I could say something to that Zen, but I'm not. Hello, Haskell. Welcome. This is just complete goofiness at the moment while I eat Pocky. And solve a murder. Sort of. Alright.
What do you think of Christina?
I don't know Christina well, but when this woman walks into a room, you can feel
you're
the
never that rough,
of
like,
adrenaline rise, that's
ever?
For sure.
Even just a little?
I would love it if you could tell me a little about Sonia.
Sonia's my sibling, dude.
Indeed.
She's an awesome, intelligent, and generous woman, always attentive to the needs of others.
Indeed.
In short, she's a super sister.
Man, she's a super sister. Man.
What do you think of Colio?
Sorry, man. I don't know him.
The shit.
What do you know about Lorenzo Battaglieri?
Lorenzo has talent. And those who tell you otherwise are lying and probably jealous. He's my friend, and I find it disgusting that he was put aside by Nolent and my grandfather. Lorenzo was, in a way, their scapegoat, you know?
Scapegoat for what, you dipstick?
What do you think of Baina?
Ah, Baina. That natural, young, beautiful, who makes men's heads turn. Well, except mine, of course.
Oh, he's got a thing for the native girl.
I would like to know more about Martin.
Yeah, great guy.
He wants to hover.
Don't tease him too much, you know. He's rather susceptible.
She's mute. She can't say no.
Otherwise, okay.
Haskell, right? Is that, like, not the most annoying thing ever that they're talking and they're going like this and their mouths aren't moving? I keep trying to not look at their faces when they're talking because it's driving me nuts. I don't understand why as much time as they took into making the rest of the scenery and everything look really good, why couldn't they have a mouth animation? Even if it was just a stupid puppety one. I mean, come on.
What do you think of the attorney, Hubert de Noland?
Ha! Noland. He's a real poet, huh? If I could earn a tenth of what he does thanks to his shrewdness at robbing the IRS, then I can tell you I'd be rich.
What can you tell me about Marco?
Marco, he was always grandfather's pet. Even when we were children, he was the favorite. And the old man helped him hugely in his political success.
Yeah, they could have at least done something. I mean, really. They have the movement. They have the blinks. They have, like...
My stomach is growling. It's the moment to go and get a bite to eat.
Hey, man. Okay, now he looks like he's eating a piece of wood. Literally, that looks like he's chewing on a log. That's because you're talented, Myrtle.
Here we go. An efficient meal.
I literally walked away from dude so he could go stuff his face. Oh, you guys. That's good shit right there. Fuck me. I gotta walk all the way back down to the kitchen? Right of a view on Steve. Their mouths don't move, right? You figured out my secret. Oh no! Oh my god. Do I want to go this way? Shit, man. I gotta finish talking to you people. What the fuck? Wait a minute. You're a lady. Where are you?
Good morning, miss. I'm Jack Knorr, police inspector.
Wait, where'd the
I'm charged with routine investigation of the death of Mr. Jones.
Good morning, Mrs. Jones. Clara Jones. I'm Billy Jones's wife. Walter Jones was his grandfather, but I didn't really know him. So I will be direct with you. I'm not really in an awful state about his death.
If it doesn't bother you, I'd love to take a photo of your hands, please.
Go on. I imagine this is part of your job, Inspector.
Thanks.
Rapture's breaking it down, man. Okay. Oh, god damn it. Billy Jones, blah, 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 blah. Picture of hers. Her hands look completely fine. Although she has some schmutz on her shirt. Not gonna say anything about that. Just keep moving.
Excuse me. Just one question. It won't be too long. What can you tell me regarding the death of Walter Jones?
I have de Nolan's version. He said that he went to the Tortoise Belvedere where Walter Jones had fallen from the top of the cliff in his wheelchair.
This lady kind of sounds like one of the
Whether it was
Powerpuff
an accident
girls.
Or murder, that I can't say. I wasn't at the site, Inspector.
I think. or sort of like Mandy from Billy and Mandy.
Where were you and what were you doing last night?
Well, I was at the restaurant throughout the evening, and I can't say anything more. It was Nolan who informed us about Walter's death.
Just in time, trying to save the world.
What was your relationship with Walter Jones?
Would you be surprised if I said that our relationship was far from good? His death won't change anything. This guy hurt a lot of people. I won't cry for him.
Who is the rightful owner of this piece of chain?
These links are really strong. It must be a man's.
It must be a man's.
This tower on this wild island, far from everything. Ooh. Isn't it madness?
Tell me, Inspector. Are you here to have a good time or to conduct an investigation?
She kind of has like that dead eye sort of thing because they're such bright blue eyes, and it's kind of creeping me out.